Joining us this morning to tell us more about their investigation into the alleged abuse of distressed OFWs in the Middle East is AKBAYAN Representative Walden Bello. He's chairman of the House Committee on Overseas Workers Affairs. Congressman, good morning.
Good morning, Pinky.
All right, what is the allegation? I understand that being a chairman or being the chairman of the Overseas Committee in the House of Representatives, you made the rounds in the Middle East. You visited Saudi Arabia, didn't you?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And you nangala po kayo ng mga reports, statements, and let's start with that.
Yeah.
Ano yung na-discover niyo then?
Well, first of all, in the last 3 years, I have visited a number of countries, including Saudi Arabia, Lebanon, Syria, in different, on different missions. No? Now, this one recently is, the report about sex for flight came up. And when we heard about it, we immediately launched an investigation. No? And, the people that we approached here were people within the DOLE and the DFA. And they came out. These are the people that came out with these reports and with documents. No? Mm. Because they had been frustrated that they said that all of these activities have been known all along, but that superiors were not acting on it.
Wait a minute, but you said you're getting documents talking about the sex for flight. You were getting documents from the DOLE and the DFA?
Yes. Okay.
Are you talking about the main officer?
Yes. These are central officers of the DOLE and the DFA.
No, here.
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 Yes.
Because DFA Assistant Secretary Raul Hernandez had just said that there has been no formal complaint and he wants to I think you are supposed to meet each other or discuss this, but
with Secretary Del Rosario.
Well, I'm still talking about Asik Raul Hernandez because he was the one interviewed on radio or television. He said that no formal complaint has been filed. There is still nothing when it comes to the subject on the sex for flight.
No.
But you're telling me you're getting documents from
yes.
the DFA.
Well, let me clarify, because this was very clear from the very start, that in the case of Damascus, this was a case of a member of the augmentation team, nicknamed Kim, who was exploiting overseas Filipino workers, distressed workers, and had been consistently doing it in violation of the word guardian relationship. And they were very worried themselves, and they documented this, and we have the documents, including the affidavits by witnesses of an incident that took place at the poolside on January 1st of an intimate act committed by this person with a distressed OFW that is banned by the rules of the embassy. Now, we have the documents, and what we were surprised about is that this person was merely given a penalty of attending a gender sensitivity course, whereas in fact this merits dismissal from the position right away. No? Ngayon, dun naman sa
may I ask why gender sensitivity?
Definitely somebody should undergo gender sensitivity. All of us should undergo that. But this one was a serious, serious offense, no? And this really merits a dismissal.
Yes, I understand. But what you're saying is that in Damascus, in January 1, did you receive the report?
Yes,
sir.
Yes, affidavits.
You got an affidavit from where?
From the DFA office itself. We have the full documentation on this person.
This person, okay.
This is why I'm surprised that Asik Hernandez has said they don't have any reports of this.
Okay, so let's clear it, Congressman. January 1, sometime in January, you were
New Year's party.
Wow, that's why I was thinking January
poolside.
1.
January 1, poolside, midnight. Intimate act between a member of the augmentation team and a distressed OFW, and this was documented with affidavits that were available and sent to the central office.
I understand. Here. Okay, so this is this alleged Kim.
Yes.
Who is the suspect.
Yes.
Right. And then there is a woman who was supposed to have been exploited.
Yes. The fifth.
The
fifth woman who had been exploited.
And how all five were recorded? Sinumbong lahat ng lima? All five, or ito lang the fifth
well,
one?
Well, this one was documented and the other four were known by the embassy officials themselves.
Okay, they were known but it was not documented.
I don't know if there are documents. If there are documents on that, I still have to receive them.
All right, but what you're certain is the fifth one you're saying is the one that's documented. This woman was supposedly exploited by a certain Kim, who is a member of the augmentation force.
Yes.
Exploited in a way, how, without being too graphic, sir?
Well, having intimate relations. And this is banned under the rules of the embassy.
When you say intimate relations, sir, was it forced or was it consensual?
I cannot answer that. I can only go by the reports that they were seen in this. Now, whether or not that was forced or consensual, that has to be the subject of further investigation.
Because what you're saying is whether it's consensual or not, it's a violation.
Yes, okay. Definitely, under the rules, which is why the Damascus embassy was very concerned about this. And the problem that I have, and people in the central office here in DFA, problem is that why was he just given a tap on the wrist, whereas in fact he should be dismissed immediately.
So to clarify it, any member of the embassy or the augmentation team cannot have a relationship with any OFW for that matter.
Yes.
That's the rule.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So that's the one in Damascus. And supposedly there are five, but you're only certain of one right now.
Written documentation on one.
Okay. Mm-mm. Let's go to the next one. After Damascus, what's next?
Well, in Amman, Jordan, I was, of course, Mr. Antonio, who is the assistant labor attaché, would deny these allegations, no? Because they risk criminal prosecution at this point in time. But, this person has been running a prostitution ring.
How do you know that?
This comes from sources within DOLE and DFA themselves, okay?
Also?
This has been known for some time, that this individual lets out his wards at around 11 p.m. at night, and that he sells them to rich Palestinian men in Amman, and that this has become such a scandal in Amman that even the Jordanian government has already asked the Philippine government to recall this man. Otherwise, they will declare him persona non grata. It's come to a point whereby the Jordanians themselves want to get rid of this guy and paralyze pa rin yung atin officials. The ambassador was very concerned about this, tried to set up a sort of surveillance of the guy, but certainly, I mean, when the host government already asks that because of criminal activity, remove this guy, and you don't remove him, there's something very wrong.
How do you know that the Jordanian government has actually asked for this, for Mr. Antonio to be removed or taken out of
that? Yes,
Jordan?
I got that from very reliable sources within the DFA and DOLE.
But do you have evidence, a paper, note verbal?
I don't have that at this point, but I trust my sources. Uh-huh. And I dare them to deny. I dare the DOLE and DFA to deny that the Jordanian government has asked for the dismissal of this person from Jordan. I dare them to deny that the Jordanian government has asked, has threatened to declare this guy persona non grata.
Let me ask you this. You're getting these from your sources, but if the Jordanian government is already asking for Mr. Antonio to be dismissed or taken away from their country, from Jordan, why would the Philippines not do that?
Well, this
why would the Philippines not recall him?
This is what puzzles me. You know, I mean, obviously, this guy, Antonio, and the guy Marquez, who's been there for a long, long time, engaging in the same sort of thing of running a sexual prostitution ring, has not been disciplined even when he was cheating Filipinos, which was documented by the Committee on Audit. No? So, obviously, these guys are quite powerful within the embassies, okay? And there's a hesitation on the part of our officials there to discipline them. And there's a hesitation on the part of people here to discipline them. So what is the source of this power? Kasi these are supposed to be low-level, relatively low-level officials, and yet they're running criminal operations out of Philippine embassies.
Is it possible that your story could be exaggerated?
Of course, there's always a possibility, but I trust my sources very well. These are people that of known integrity, and these are people who would not be telling lies because I know their record. And I've been able to observe their record when they in the performance of their duties. These are the people that really feel bad that a few bad eggs smear the reputation of Dole, the embassy, and the
DFA.
The DFA. No, and busit na bisit na sila.
But did you even try, in your capacity as chairman of the House Committee on Overseas Workers, to speak to even DFA Assistant Secretary Raul Hernandez or the secretary himself of the DFA? Or what about the Dole?
No, I decided to go immediately out because I wanted this out to the public right away.
Because you wanted...
I've spoken to people within Dole and DFA. And this is the reason that I came out with this, because the news was awful, and this this was something that the public ought to know. Ngayon, how the Dole.
But why did it take forever? Why did it take a representative Bello to even come up with something like this? When you're saying the Dole had the documents, you're saying the DFA had the documents.
Well, this is my big question. These are the pimping activities of Marquez and Antonio have been known for some time. They're known throughout the Middle East. They're known in all of the our officials there, and yet these guys, these criminals, have gotten scot-free. And nagtatanong nga ako, bakit kaya that these guys are so defiant and have such...
So what's your suspicion?
My suspicion is that probably on the part of the central office, a desire to avoid scandal, and on the part of people there, like for instance, their superiors in the embassies there, baka natatakot that these guys have a lot of information about other goings-on in these embassies. And we cannot discount the fact that if you are running a prostitution ring out of a Philippine embassy, that you have local contacts with the local mafia. No? Siyempre, pag may contacts yan sa mga mafia, at sasabihin mo, official ka ng embassy, that we will discipline you, I can imagine that they would hesitate to act if these guys have contacts with local criminal elements.
Congressman, to be fair, of course, to those even being accused, you mentioned to me that in Damascus, there's a documentation of this woman being exploited by a certain Kim. Okay, meron yan. In Jordan, now comes a prostitution ring, an alleged prostitution ring. What's your evidence?
We have that email backs traffic.
You have what?
Email traffic.
What exactly is that?
Well, we have email traffic of correspondence between officials, regarding this very great.
For example, like what? Like we're talking about the prostitution ring?
Yes.
Mr. Antonio himself?
No, not Mr. Antonio. But this is email traffic regarding Mr. Antonio.
What you're trying to tell me, sir, is that there are people, you have copies of emails of people possibly in Jordan?
Mm-mm.
Talking to each other, corresponding through email, talking about this alleged prostitution ring?
Yes, expressing concern about it.
Do you have women who are actually complaining?
No, we are in fact asking victims to come forward, especially with respect to the Kuwait and Jordan incidents, but you have to realize that these are OFWs who are scared, okay, who are worried about possible consequences. We have an OFW in Kuwait as well as one in Jordan that has been considering filing a formal complaint, but still have to make decisions because of their worry about possible consequences. But for me, if the complaints have been consistent, no? Noong nagsimula si Mr. Antonio in Tokyo, in Beirut, and in Amman, and these accusations have been leveled about him in all of these three areas. This is in the Filipino community in Jordan complains, and the Jordanian government itself complains. I mean, come on, let's move. Mm-hmm. No, tanggalin na yan, isibak, criminal prosecution. Of course, he will have his day in court, but we owe it to our OFWs to remove such people. This guy Marquez in Kuwait, he's been there for a long time. He was involved, he was a close associate of Shulan Primavera, who was recalled because of molesting as an OFW. He was a close associate of former labor attaché, assistant labor attaché Ofelia de Castro, who was removed because of human trafficking. This guy was intimately involved in all of this, yet he remains. Natanggal na itong dalawang mataas,
na
mas mataas sa kanya, nandun pa rin siya engaging in what one of our correspondents described as nefarious activities. At kwanyana, this guy is a local hire, contractual employee. Now, how come a lowly contractual employee could have such power and such to act with such impunity? Kaya, at alam na nito, sa, you know, come on, I mean...
What you're saying is people talk... What I'm really getting from you is it's a known secret. It's an open secret.
It's well known in Dole. It's well known in DFA. And it's a crime that they have not been acted on.
Surely it is a crime. Number one, it's a crime if it's true. Number two, it's a crime if they've not been acting on this. But when you launch an investigation, Congressman, you will need witnesses.
Of course.
Who's going to come forward?
Well, we will... Well, first of all, I fully support the Dole investigation that has begun. I fully support the DFA investigation that has begun. Yung limitations namin sa Congress is that we're now on recess.
Yeah.
And we don't come back till July 22.
July 22, that's
and,
right.
But as soon as it opens, I'm not sure whether I'll still be the head of the Committee on Overseas Workers Affairs, but even if I'm not the head, I will file a resolution for an investigation. I trust naman that the House
will look into this.
It. And Malacanang has already said, priority ito.
So, the Dole has its investigation, the DFA has its investigation. Have they called you? Have they asked to...
Yes.
Makita naman tayo bukas or today?
Well, I have had contact with people in Dole, especially this morning when I was here in Umaga Kay Ganda.
Yeah.
Secretary Del Rosario will be meeting with me later this morning.
Oh,
in fact,
go.
I need to go soon.
What time is your meeting with the Secretary?
We'll be meeting at around 10:30.
To discuss this.
Yes, I think that I'm very glad that the secretary has asked for this meeting.
Do you have full trust and confidence in Secretary Albert Del Rosario that he will look into this?
I have trust and confidence in Secretary Del Rosario and Secretary Baldos. I have known them, and they are upright individuals. I have a sense that they did not know what
was
going on.
That's what I wanted to ask you. Do you think it never got to them?
Well, I think that they didn't know about this, that this was not brought to their attention. And alam naman natin na si Secretary Del Rosario has been so busy dealing with China on this West Philippine Sea issue. So, but now that it has been called to his attention, he's moving very quickly on this.
Have you opened any lines or your emails or... for those who might want to seek your help, since you're the one who's actually come out, na posibleng mayroong talagang gusto magsumbong sa inyo.
Yes. I mean, I announced that already that they should be able to approach me, and clearly, as I said, whoever approaches me now, we will promise them protection. Okay, whether they're OFWs or whistleblowers within the bureaucracy. Kasi right now, I am relying on whistleblowers, but extremely reliable ones.
You're getting your information from whistleblowers, but you're not yet getting information from the victims themselves.
Yes, and they have to come forward. They have to make up their mind. At the same time, you cannot just force them because... Natatakot yan.
What about the issue on the sex for flight? Was that...
Well, this our initial investigation was sex for flight, and then we uncovered na mas malaki pala ito. You know, so
yun pala yung umpisa lang.
Yeah, yung sex for flight, you know, this is something that goes on apparently from what we've heard in both Jordan and Kuwait, but as I said, it was a much bigger issue kasi mas malaki pala, it was a prostitution ring. Mm-hmm. And so I'm not really surprised that if you're running a prostitution ring with criminal elements in Jordan, the Jordanian government will ask for your dismissal. You know? So, I mean, this is quite serious.
It could have been possible to Congressman, did you think that, if so, that the Jordanian government could have filed a case against Mr. Antonio if they wanted him out already and they knew that he was supposedly, he had a prostitution ring?
I'm not exactly sure why they didn't. Maybe, you know naman, diplomats and diplomatic immunity. You know, exactly why they didn't. Could it be because they could not do it because of diplomatic immunity?
Okay, but
what is clear is that they ask.
All right.
The Philippine government.
Okay, what's important is your meeting with Secretary Albert Del Rosario. Mm-hmm. I know you have to go, sir. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can tell us more about it after your meeting, and we'll continue to find out more information on this.
Yes, I just hope that in both the DFA and the DOLE that there isn't a cover-up. I was just surprised when Administrator Dimson said she was shocked by the allegations. Kasi alam na naman nila. Alam na ni Administrator Dimson na nangyayari ito. And so I think she should just not be using words like, it shocks me that these allegations come out.
Congressman Walden Bello, sir, thank you so much for coming over and good luck with your meeting with the Secretary, sir. Thanks a lot.
Okay, thank you.